Hello guys, welcome to another video tutorial, and in this video we will cover the topic of multiple select drop down list in ASP.NET MVC. So this is the continuation of our last video in which we covered the drop down using viewback approach and the model approach, and now we will use this project to convert the drop down list into the multiple selection of drop down. So let's go back to the Visual Studio, and here is the same project which I worked on last two videos. So in order to render multiple drop down select list, first of all we need to install a NuGet package. So I will go into the Solution Explorer and right click on the project, and here we will select the option Manage NuGet package for project, and in the browse tab we will type bootstrap.chosen. As you can see, here is the package which we need to install, bootstrap.chosen by lzipped, and we will install this in our project. So let's click on install button. It is installing the package in our project. So let's wait for it to complete. I will click on OK. As you can see in the output window, our package has been installed successfully. So now I will close this NuGet package window, and I will go into the Solution Explorer, and here we have the content folder. And you can see the chosen files here, bootstrap.chosen, and the package related files exist in content folder, and some files exist in the script folder. As you can see here, chosen.jquery.js. So our next step is to create a bundle for this. So I will go into the bundle config in app start folder, and now we will create a bundle for it. I will make it a little bit zoom for you guys to understand it better. I have already written this code, so I will paste it here. So as you can see, we have added a bundle for our chosen files. Okay, in the script folder we have chosen.jquery file, and in the content we have bootstrap-chosen.css. So that's it for the bundle.config file. Now we will go back into the home index VM where we have created company select list in our last video. I will recommend you to watch my previous videos. I have already mentioned links in the description box. You can watch it to better understand this concept. What I will do now, I will create another property which will be of private multi-select list, and name will be company multi-select list, and will provide get and set method as well. And similarly we will create a public property to access the fields, public multi-select list company multi-select list, and will provide getter and setter for this as well. So in the get we will check if our private property is not equal to null, then we need to return _ company multi-select list private property. Otherwise we need to return new, let's make it in center to better view, new multi-select list. And in this multi-select list, first of all we need to pass our list, and second one will be the text field, data value field, and third one will be the tax field. So we have the tax field as well. Let's make it method predictable. And similarly, we need to set the value as well. So underscore company multi select list is equal to value. So that's it for the model. So as you can see, we have followed the same step which we have covered in our last video, but the difference is in place of select list, now we have used the multi select list. So now we will go back to the index view where we were working on the drop downs. So what I will do, I will copy this code and paste it here, and I will change the heading to multi select drop down, and now I will change the ID to company ID. And similarly, here we need to pass the multi select list. So model dot company multi select list, and we need to change it to the multi select list as well. Okay guys, I hope you understand this. And similarly, we need to pass some more attributes to make it multiple. So here we need to pass it the multiple equal to multiple. This is very important step, because if we couldn't provide this attribute in the drop-down list, then our drop-down will no longer be multiple. So we must provide this, and let's add another class to make it multiple. So we provide this to chosen company. Okay, now we need to access this class in our jQuery portion, and then we will apply the plugin that we have installed in the starting of the video. So let's add the section for scripts. So section scripts, and here in the section script we need to provide a script tag, and type will be text slash javascript, and in this we need to initialize the jQuery DOM functionality. So dollar function and open and closing brackets as well, and in this portion we need to apply the plugin for our drop down. So now we need to access the element on which apply the plugin. So we have used the class on our control, so we will provide the same class here and will apply the chosen plugin on it. So this line, what it will do, it will make this control representing the class of chosen dash company and apply the chosen plugin, multi select plugin, on this control. And last not the least, remember we have added two bundles in our bundle config file. So we need to reference these two bundles in our index view. So let's go back to the index view, and similarly we will add the section styles in our view as well, and we need to reference the bundles. So add styles dot render, and we need to pass the bundle. So the bundle, we need to pass the path of the bundle, so with the tilde sign and content slash chosen. Okay, and similarly we need to pass the script bundle as well. So here we will provide the scripts dot render, and in this we need to pass the bundle as well. So first of all the tilde sign, and then bundles and last is the chooser. If you look at the bundle.config, you will better understand. So we created a bundle by this name and this name, and same we have used it here. So you don't need to confuse about this. You can call whatever you want it, and you can replace that name here. And I think we have finished for this. So let's build our project and run the project by pressing Control F5. So I will press Control F5 to run the project, and let's see what we have got. I hope we will get a proper result, and our drop down will be multi-select. Our project is loading, and as you can see here, we have got an error which is saying the following section have been defined but have not been rendered for the layout. So here it is complaining about the style section which we have passed in the index. So let's go back to the Visual Studio. As you can see, we have passed the style section here. So it is complaining about this section that we need to fix. So I have found a fix for it, so I will provide it to you. So to fix this problem, we need to go into the layout file. So you can go into the Solution Explorer, and in the Views folder we have another folder which named Shared, and in the Shared folder we have underscore layout file as well. So here we need to declare the section of styles. So in order to render this section, we need to pass the method of render section, and in this we need to pass styles, our section name, and required will be false. So I hope you understand this concept, and in order to check this, you can also search on internet and you have found the lots of solution. So let's again build our project, and let's go back to the Chrome and let's refresh this page, and I hope now it will work according to our requirement. And here it is, our page has been loaded successfully, and here we have multiple select drop down. So in this we have option at select company and company 1, company 2. So we will select company 1, company 2 and company 3. So here it is working properly. I hope you find this video helpful, and it is very good to understand this topic, because in every real life project we need to cover this type of topics, and in our forms or registrations. So it is very important to understand the concept, and I would recommend you to watch my previous two videos in which we have covered drop down using model approach and Lubeck approach, and then we will use these two approaches to make it the multiple select down list. Okay guys, I hope you find this video helpful, and if you find this video helpful, kindly like this video and subscribe my channel, and I hope guys you will implement this on your side as well. So thank you for watching. Have a nice day.